Kid Life. Happy Easter! Woo-hoo! He says Happy Easter too.
Yes, hello my friends. Welcome to Kid Life and Happy Easter. We at Kid Life want to say thank you to all the friends that sent in pictures, the thank you pictures for the essential workers. We made a video of your amazing pictures that we'll show near the end of this video. So stay tuned, you don't want to miss it. You guys did an awesome job. But right now, we are going to pray. My friend Prince is going to open us up in prayer.
Father God, thank you for making this day. Thank you for making everyone. Forgive us for all our sins. Protect us from the coronavirus. Thank you for helping us do our work and do all our things we need to do. Please bless my church and my people. Bless the whole church. In Jesus' name, amen.
We tried having Easter Lego Olympics, but it wasn't the same without you. It was pretty pitiful. Take a look.
This is like tricks. It's just for kids. Okay, ready.
I miss the kids.
Who is this guy?
I won again!
This guy's so strong.
I am the champion! Oh yeah!
Everything's not awesome.
We miss the kids.
But God is still awesome.
Isn't that right, Theodore?
Hey, I've got an idea. How about we postpone it until all the kids come back?
You know what?
What?
That's actually not a bad idea.
I have some of those sometimes.
So that's what we'll do. We're gonna postpone the Easter Lego Olympics to the after Easter Lego Olympics. The date will be announced once everyone is back in Kid Life.
Great idea!
So keep praying, keep practicing. We'll see you soon. Be safe.
Now, let's get out my friend Vern.
Always get out my glove.
Vern? Happy Easter! Happy Easter to you, bud. Come get on my arm.
I'm so excited. Hello! Happy Easter!
I love that you are so excited about Easter.
I am, and I'm hungry!
Oh, what are you looking at them for?
Worms?
I think he wants you to feed him some worms. Can you feed him some worms? Oh, thank you. Ready?
Thank you.
That was very kind of you.
Now, Vern, it's time to find out what's in the mystery box.
Oh boy, it's a worm.
It's not what you want it to be.
Let's take a look and see.
It's gonna be nothing. Nothing.
You see? But that's all right. Now it's time for you to read the clue, Vern. Okay, go ahead and warm up your reading voice. Okay. All right, you ready?
Oh, there is something in the mystery box that you don't know what it is.
You don't know what it is? What could that be? What do you think it is?
I guess we're gonna find out.
I think it's a horn.
Of course you do. Let's take a look and see.
I can taste it now. It's a worm.
Is it a worm?
No.
It's not a worm. But Vern, it is something very interesting. It's a surprise gift. Because a surprise is something we don't know that's coming. We don't know what it is. It's a surprise gift. Look, there's a question mark, just like on the mystery box.
I want to see.
Okay, all right, Vern.
Get it. Not a worm.
Yeah. It's not. Let's show everybody what it is. It's a cross.
Why is there a cross in there?
Well, Vern, it's because we're celebrating Easter today. And we celebrate Easter because Jesus rose from the dead on Easter. But before Easter happened, Good Friday happened and Jesus died on the cross for our sins. That's when he defeated death. But he didn't stay dead. He rose from the dead on Easter. So that's why the cross is in there.
Wow.
And that was a surprise to a lot of people, even though he actually did tell them he was gonna die. And Jesus did that so he could make a way that we could know God. That's what's so awesome about Easter.
Ow, I love Easter.
And you know what? There's something else in here.
It's a worm!
No, it's not a worm. It's actually my friend, Gus the guinea pig.
I think you need a thrush, Gus.
You might need a brush.
Why does he got that?
Well, Gus is a guinea pig, but he is trying to be a bunny. He's wearing these blue ears.
I'll help ya.
So does wearing those blue ears make Gus a bunny?
No.
I guess in his imagination, but no, there's nothing Gus can do to be a bunny, right?
All right.
That's right, Vern. So there's nothing Gus can do to be a bunny, and it's just like us. There's nothing we can do to get to God on our own. We cannot be good enough to get to God. And just coming to church, you know, that does not make us closer to God or make us a Christian. It's just like if I go stand in a garage, Vern, does that make me a car?
No.
See? So God didn't want it that way. So he sent Jesus to make a way on the cross that we could know him.
Awesome.
Yeah, it is pretty awesome. And we're gonna leave this stuff out here because we're gonna get it later. But Vern, we've got lots more to discover and see about Easter, and I'm gonna let you go in your box so you can watch from your box, okay?
I wanna sing about Easter!
You can sing about Easter in your box, right?
I wanna sing to them, Jesus is alive!
I know he is, we love him.
Jesus!
I know, we love him.
It's alive!
Okay, Vern.
Bye. Bye! See you later. Happy Easter!
Happy Easter, Vern.
Sorry.
I know you're excited. Now that I put Vern away, I thought you would enjoy seeing some of this video footage of Vern Zooming with some of his puppet friends. See, Zoom is a way online that we can communicate and see our friends and talk and visit with them while we can't see them in person. And Vern wanted to be kind and check on his friends and see how they were doing. So let's take a look and see. All right, Vern, we're calling Pete the possum. We got an earpiece so you can hear him.
I don't got an ear,
but I'll hold it up for you.
Can you move over?
Why is that?
I want a little privacy.
Well, Vern, you're a puppet, so I have to hold you, okay?
Okay, but over there.
Okay, I'll move over a little bit over here.
Wait a minute! There's a worm! I didn't get it!
Well, uh-oh. Pete, sorry, Nan. Pete, you're frozen. Let's try to call again. Now, hey, Pete!
Ah, good to see you, Vern.
So good to see you, too.
But, I see myself. Look at my hair.
Whoa, it's a little...
I haven't had a haircut in a while.
It's a little, yeah, a little crazy like you are.
I'm a barber, you know.
I know. Yep, me too. My roots are growing out. But, hey, Nan, you still look pretty good. That's why I wanted to call and check on you. You doing all right?
Well, I'm doing good. Learning patience with my little brother. He's been grabbing my guitar with his teeth.
Oh, that's awful! Hey, I hope you washed it.
That's a good point.
Don't put your hands on your face. Nor your tail.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah.
You know how I always think your tail is a worm. It always, I'm like, oh, look, it's a worm! And then I'm like, nah, it's Pete's tail. Ah.
Yeah.
Well, it won't be long. We'll see each other again. But this Zoomin's pretty cool.
Yeah. It's neat for you too.
I'm gonna sing an Easter song.
No, Vern, you really don't have to do that.
Jesus is alive! Wanted me to sing some more?
It's okay. You can just make me another card.
What are you trying to say? Hey, Gino! Hey, for your friends out there, that's Chido. He's a goat, and Chido means goat in Spanish. Hola, Chido! He said hello. Did you get the card? Yep, Miss Utherin. You're my amigo! That means friend in Spanish.
Oh, that's right.
Wait, I thought you weren't listening. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm over here. Hey, I got a little Easter song for you. What? No? You gotta go? Fine. I'll sing it as you go. Yep. Ain't no rock gonna cry in the Hey, Diego!
So good to see you, my friend. Wait. I have to turn my head because I'm a dinosaur. Doing, Vern?
Okay, I'm trying to remember to be thankful. How are you?
Oh, thank you. I needed to be reminded to be thankful.
Yes.
Because I'm going crazy. I mean, I'm okay. Okay.
You're okay. And that's why I sent you the card too to cheer you up. Did you get it?
Oh, I sure did. Look at it.
Thank you.
So beautiful and amazing and artistic.
It was made with love. I wanted to cheer you up.
Oh, it did. It brought a big, big, toothy smile to my face. Like this.
I love your smile. You got a lot of teeth. I don't got any teeth, see?
I have plenty of time to brush them now.
But
I brush them a lot.
You still have to brush your beak, even though you don't have teeth, because your breath would stink.
Ooh. I still brush. I got a pointy beak, see?
And I am working on my thank you to the essential workers.
Oh, I see. It says thank you. That's going to be great.
Yes, it is hard to color with my tiny arms, but I do what I can.
I know T-Rexes do have tiny arms, but you do a great job. You do. I have a surprise song for you. Because it's Easter. Yeah. Why does everybody get quiet?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm just gonna sing a little song.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay, here goes. 1, 2, 3, 4, I love Jesus! Did you like it?
It was very passionate.
All right, then. See you later.
Okay, goodbye.
Bye.
Hey, everybody. It's Easter weekend. It's the time when we celebrate the fact that Jesus is alive. Now, I'm sure you already knew it was Easter weekend, right? I mean, it's not like Easter comes along and takes us by surprise. Speaking of surprise, that's exactly what your lesson is about today. It's all about how Jesus was a big surprise to the people of his day. You know, sometimes surprises can be really cool. Like when you reach into your burger meal and you find out it comes with a toy. Surprise! Or like when you were so worried about that massive science test that you were going to have to take, and then you got to class and your teacher announced a surprise.
What? It's an open book test? Yes!
Those are the best surprises, huh? But you know, sometimes surprises turn out not to be a good thing. Like when you're eating popcorn and suddenly you find a surprise. Yuck! Or when you thought you were home alone, but then a member of your family comes around the corner and surprises you. Today, in your Easter lesson, you're going to learn that Jesus was a big surprise to the people of his day. He was a leader that the people didn't really expect, and he did many things that they really didn't expect. But on Easter Sunday morning, those people got a huge surprise. Well, I don't want to talk too much, because there's nothing worse than spoiling the surprise. I'll see you next time. Happy Easter.
What's up? Ah, yeah! What's up, everybody? It's me! It's the SKI to the DLEF. Skittles in the hizzy, and I'm ready to tell you what's up! I am so excited that it's Easter, baby! Today, we are learning a lesson called
Surprise!
Don't do that to me! Like I was saying, today's lesson is called
Surprise!
You gotta stop doing that! Anyway, in our lesson today, we are learning all about how Jesus is alive. So every time somebody asks you, what's up, you tell them. Don't be surprised, Jesus is alive. That's right. Jesus died on a cross, but he didn't stay dead. No way. On the third day, surprise, Jesus rose from the grave. Up from the grave he arose with a mighty triumph for his foes. Jesus delivered the greatest surprise of all that awesome Easter morning. And that is why we celebrate Easter. So anytime somebody asks you, what's up, you tell them. Don't be surprised, Jesus is alive. And that right there is what's up on Easter. I got a rainbow of flavor, and I'm living for my Savior. Skittles out, baby, yeah.
All right, boys and girls, it's time to stand up and get ready for worship.
So high above.
yet slain for us. You alone are worthy, and the praise is yours, and the praise is yours.
Oh,
It all revolves around your throne. Who can know your glory?
Yes, Jesus. All right, Scruffy, ready to learn today's memory verse? Today's memory verse comes out of the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 5 and 6. Are you ready? All right, let's say it together. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. The angel said, "You are looking for Jesus. He isn't here. He has been raised from the dead." Matthew 28, 5 and 6. Hey, Scruffy, can you say that? Close enough.
Next, Pastor Brandon has a great Bible story and a wonderful message to share.
Jesus began his ministry on earth at the age of 30. When he showed up, he took everyone by surprise. He spent 3 years preaching God's love to the world and performing miracles. Jesus' 12 disciples knew Jesus had promised to set up God's kingdom on earth. He was going to be the ruler of the world. One day, something terrible happened. Jesus was arrested, beaten, and sentenced to death. His hands and feet were nailed to a cross. The soldiers laughed at him and made fun of him. The disciples couldn't believe it. They expected Jesus to fight back and defeat his enemies. Jesus surprised everyone when he didn't fight back. Instead, he prayed for God to forgive the people who were hurting him. Sadly, Jesus died on the cross that day. The disciples were even more surprised. Hadn't Jesus told us he was the Son of God? How could this be happening to him? He promised to set up his kingdom, but now he's dead. The disciples surely began to lose hope. They thought God's plan had failed. They expected Jesus to instantly save himself, but that didn't happen. Jesus' body was placed in a tomb, and a large stone was rolled over the entrance. 3 days later, some women came to the tomb to anoint Jesus' body with some perfume. Guess what they found? They found the biggest surprise of all. Jesus' body wasn't there, only his grave clothes that he had taken off. Suddenly, an angel appeared to the women and said, "Why are you looking for Jesus? He isn't here. He is risen from the dead." The women went to find the disciples to tell them the good news. Surprise! Jesus is alive! What an amazing story. Jesus surprised everyone by rising from the dead. Because Jesus is alive, we celebrate Easter. We celebrate because Jesus conquered death and the grave. He made it possible for us to have new life in him. Today in our lesson, we're going to learn all about how Jesus was the biggest surprise in the history of the world.
Guys, I am so excited that today is Easter. Easter is one of my most favorite holidays.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear Brandon! Happy birthday to you!
And many more!
Aren't surprise parties so much fun? One second you don't know anything about it that you're going to be celebrated, then all of a sudden, surprise! Here you are, the focus and center of attention. But, guys, I got some bad news.
What?
It's not my birthday.
What?
What? What? I'm sorry, guys. Surprise? Well, that wasn't very good, I guess. I guess my surprise to them that it's not my birthday wasn't really a good one at all. But it's true. While sometimes surprises can be a great thing, sometimes they can be a bad thing. You know, sometimes it's like the kid who just got home from school and found out that their dad has left home and that his parents were getting a divorce. Or sometimes it's like the little girl that spent the night at her friend's house and then comes back home to find mom and dad sitting in the living room sad, and she wonders why, and she learns the surprising news that her grandmother just died. Not a good surprise at all. Life sometimes can surprise you. You know, sometimes they're good, but sometimes they're not the greatest thing ever. And today, I want to share with you some surprise facts about the Easter story that we heard just a little bit ago. Though that I think you will learn some important things about Jesus, and some of them actually will surprise you. So Like the first thing, Jesus was a surprise to the people of his day. When Jesus came on the scene, he surprised everyone with his knowledge of God, his love for people, and his amazing power to heal the blind, the crippled, and all those who were sick. They had never seen anyone with this kind of power. In addition to that, Jesus surprised them with his teaching. He challenged them in ways that he could never imagine. He challenged them to love God more, to not fight back when they were treated unfairly, and to trust God with their whole life. Jesus made a huge impact on thousands of people's lives. But then something horrible happened. Jesus was arrested, beaten, and nailed to a cross. He died on the cross on what we now call Good Friday. It doesn't seem like a very good Friday when you think about it. He died. But there is something that you need to understand. The cross was not a surprise to Jesus. Jesus was not surprised when he was arrested. He wasn't surprised when he was sentenced to death. And Jesus wasn't surprised when he was nailed to the cross. The cross was not a surprise to Jesus. He knew it was going to happen. In fact, when Jesus left heaven to come to earth, he knew he was going to die on a cross. The cross was not a surprise to Jesus. The cross was a choice. Jesus chose to die on the cross. And you may ask, now why would he choose to die? Well, it's because of this little thing called sin. See, sin happens when we disobey God's commands in the Bible, whether that's lying, cheating, disobeying our parents, stealing, whatever. Sin is something that the Bible says that will send us to, you know, down there. Hell is a horrible place that was created for the devil and his angels. But when we sin, we deserve to go there as well. See, Jesus did not want us to spend eternity down in hell, so he chose to die on the cross to pay the price for our sins. Because Jesus died on the cross, he made it possible for us to receive forgiveness from God for our sin. Isn't that amazing, the fact that Jesus loved us so much that he died for us? But the coolest surprise of this whole entire story came 3 days after Jesus died. Jesus surprised everyone when he rose from the dead. It was a fantastic Easter surprise when Jesus rose from the dead. The disciples were surprised and celebrated the fact that Jesus was alive. Jesus has been surprising everyone ever since. Many find it hard to believe that Jesus is alive. Surprise! It's true. Right now, Jesus is alive in heaven. And he is ready for every person to receive the price that he paid on the cross. He wants you to be forgiven and receive new life that comes from being forgiven of your sins. And my question to you today, boys and girls, is that will you receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior today? See, nothing about our lives is a surprise to Jesus. He knows all about us. He knows how many hairs are on our head, how many teeth we have, you know, all about us. He knows all about us. We're not a surprise to Jesus. And you might be thinking, looking at the world today, a lot of the stuff that surprised us, this Easter that we're in right now, is really surprising because we're not together as a KidLife family, person to person. But we're still able to communicate with each other with all these ways of technology. And while that might be surprising to some of us, it wasn't a surprise to Jesus. None of this really is a surprise to Jesus. But what's surprising is that he loves us no matter what. No matter what sin you've committed, no matter what you've done, no matter what you've said, no matter what you've thought, he loves you no matter what. He loves you unconditionally. So boys and girls, I don't know about you, but to know that we serve a God that loves us no matter what, oh, that is the greatest Easter surprise ever. So boys and girls, I want you to pray with me today. If you today want to say, Lord, I want you to be my forever friend. I want you to be my Lord and Savior. Jesus, I want you to come into my heart. I want you to pray this prayer with me. And I want you to believe this prayer with all your heart, because when you do that, Jesus comes into your heart. He comes right here into your heart. And he's always there, always loving, always caring. And believe it or not, he's surprising us each and every single day. So do me a favor, bow your head, close your eyes, and do me a favor, say this prayer with me. Ready? Say, Dear Lord, I thank you for sending your only son, Jesus Christ, to this earth, not only to live with us, but to die for us. God, I ask you to forgive me of all of my sins. Wash me, cleanse me, make me new. But most importantly, Jesus, come into my heart, come into my life, be my friend. I thank you so much for everything that you've done and all that you're about to do. Thank you for surprising me with this awesome gift. We love you so much. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Awesome. Here's Ellie.
Hi, happy Easter.
That's right, happy Easter. Ellie, you had a song you wanted to share with us today.
I sure do. This is part of new spring song God Made Holy.
Sing it for us.
My God made a way for me to the Easter, and then I know Jesus died for me, and I will follow him now.
Oh, I like that. Do it again.
My God made a way for me to the Easter, and then I know Jesus died for me, and I will follow him now.
Hey, you know what? We can put that video at the end of our service so they can take a look.
That'd be great. And I thought you might need a little refreshment on this little Easter day.
Oh, some water refreshment?
Uh-huh, here it comes.
Here it comes.
Oh, oh, Ellie, you got him. Oh, get him. Boy.
And here's a video of all your amazing thank you pictures for the essential workers. Check it out.
Thank you to all the frontline workers.
You are the hero of today. You spread hope along the way. You're the light in times of gray. You carry love to calm our fears. You bring a smile to dry our tears. You're the flower in the sand that still stands. You're the rock in times of need. You are who we all should be. I wanna thank you. Time, you will have changed tomorrow's lives. You who bring courage to the fight, thank you. You're even stronger than before. You can conquer any war. You're a soldier of the heart. Thank you.
Goodbye. Thank you for sharing your Easter with us. We'll see you next time.